My brothers, we go through this dunya differently. Everyone has his own path. Everyone has his own challenges and his own na'am. Some of us have been granted money. Some of us has been granted sahha, health. Others got power. Others got acceptance. But the question is, who is the true lucky or fortunate person today? Who is the one that we can look at and say, he is the most fortunate? My brothers, if you pass by a group of friends playing Monopoly game, you wouldn't look at a person who has lots of millions and houses and hotels and say, how lucky you are, you have everything in this. No, you wouldn't do that, because it's a game. 30 minutes later, the game is over, and no one remembers who was lucky in the game, right? It doesn't count, it's not real. That money, that houses, these hotels, were not real. So the actual money, to say this person was granted money, it has to be real, in this dunya at least, right? Let's look at Qarun. Allah Azza wa Jal has given Qarun a lot of money, a lot of wealth. The Quran says, وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ. The strong men wouldn't be able to carry the keys of his treasures. Imagine how wealthy he was. And then he would go out in front of the people of the Israelites, his people, in his gold and jewelries and everything, looking at them. And in this moment, the people who are poor, looking at him, and they want the dunya, they would say, قَالَ الَّذِينَ يُرِدُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا يَا لَيْتَ لَنَا مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ قَارُونَ إِنَّهُ لَذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. Oh, we really wish to have what was given to Qarun. He has all the money, he has all the jewelry, all the gold. We wish to be in his place. Then the next day, Allah Azza wa Jal caused the earth to swallow his house, his home, and himself. And he's gone deep down, buried with everything. At this moment, those people who wanted to be in his place just yesterday, they said, Alhamdulillah, we are not Qarun. Alhamdulillah. لولا أن من الله علينا لخسف بنا. We are so lucky that we're not like this man. What about the money and the gold? You wanted his place, you wanted his treasures. No, that was temporary, that was just one day and it's gone, and he's deep down, it doesn't count. He doesn't care about his money today. And my brothers, even if this money wasn't gone, even if he lived a long life, just imagine how the life of Qarun was. Today, our soft beds that we have at home is much better than the ones Qarun had. The cold water that we have, the pure fresh water that we have here in New Zealand, is better than the one he had. The smartphone that we have today gives us a lot of power, more than what he had. He thought he had everything in this dunya, and actually he had nothing. Probably his life was bad compared to ours. So who is a true lucky person then? Where is the true success then? It's not Monopoly for sure. It's not the one who has temporary money and wealth for his people for sure. Could it be happiness? Could it be the one who is the happiest in this dunya? He is the one who is successful and he is happy and satisfied? Well, the question is there any pure happiness in this dunya? Do you think there is a pure happiness that is not included in the package of happiness? A lot of risk, a lot of pain, a lot of sweat, and the fear of losing what you just gained with hard effort. There is no pure happiness in this dunya. A lot of sa'i and continuous sa'i. You get something, you're happy with it, and then the next day you're bored with the new car. You want something better. There is no complete happiness in this dunya. And you know the one who is the most happy in this dunya? When he dies, when he goes on the day of judgment, the Prophet ﷺ is saying, يُؤْتَى بِأَنْعَمِ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ. One of the people in this dunya who was the happiest. He had the best life in this dunya. But he is destined to go to hellfire in the afterlife. He will be brought forth on the day of judgment. And he will be dipped in Jahannam, just one dip, and taken out and asked, have you had any moment of comfort in your life? did you experience anything good in this in ever? He would say, لا والله, no Allah, no, never. As if all the 60, 70 years, 100 years was nothing compared to the real next life. You know, when you are having a dream, a nightmare, it's horrible, it's difficult, it looks really real, but the moment you wake up, it's gone, it's nothing. Today, you are in a completely different world. This is the same when you compare this dunya to a moment in the afterlife, it's nothing. My brothers, the problem is not in power itself or the money itself or happiness itself. The problem is it's temporary. It doesn't last. No happiness in this dunya lasts. No health in this dunya lasts. No beauty, no money, no power lasts in this dunya. There is no real happiness, there is no real success if it's not permanent. Allah Azza wa Jal is describing the status of Al Fir'aun, who were given a lot of power, a lot of wealth in compared to their times, but now they have left it to other people to inherit it. Allah is saying, كَمْ تَرَكُوا مِنْ جَنَّاتٍ وَعْيُونٍ وَزُرُوعٍ وَمَقَامٍ كَرِيمٍ وَنَعْمَةٍ كَانُوا فِيهَا فَاكِهِينَ. How many gardens and springs have they left behind? And garden and green crops and honored places, and green and fields of grain and noble dwellings, and all that life of ease that they were delighted in. كَذَلِكَ وَأَوْرَثْنَاهَا قَوْمًا آخَرِينَ. Thus all of these things today became the inheritance of other people to put in museums. This is life. The true happiness, the true success cannot be something temporary. The true happiness, the true success cannot be measured by today's world. If you look at a person today and envy him for how lucky he is, remember, you are doing exactly as the person who is envying a person playing Monopoly. It's exactly the same. It just lasts a little bit longer. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم التائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ثم أما بعد. In the case of Qarun, the righteous people who lived with Qarun, those who had the knowledge, those who had the true knowledge, they looked at the poor people who were envying Qarun and they said, ويلكم, woe unto you, ثواب الله خير, the reward of Allah is much better. What are you looking at? This is nothing compared to what is with Allah Azza wa Jal. لمن آمن وعمل صالحا, for the ones who believed and did righteous deeds. ولا يلقاها إلا الصابرون, it's only given to the patient people. My brothers, I want to give you some examples of people among us today who are fortunate, who are lucky, who are a little bit better in this race. Some people came to the Prophet ﷺ and they said, Ya Rasulullah, ذهب أهل الدثور بالأجور. The people who are rich, they took all the reward because they are giving charity. They fast like we fast, and they pray like we pray. But they are giving charity and we don't give charity. So they take a lot of reward that we don't take. So the Prophet ﷺ says, don't you know that you can give charity? Like without money you can give charity? When you say Subhanallah, it is a charity. When you say Alhamdulillah, it is charity. When you say Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, all of this is charity. When you advise someone to do something good, Al Amru bil Ma'ruf is charity. When Nahyu an al Munkar is charity, and on and on. So the people who didn't have much money, they are not happy. They are happy now because they can give charity without money. Then later on, they came back to the Prophet saying, سَمِعَ إِخْوَانُنَا أَهْلِ الْأَمْوَالِ بِمَا فَعَلْنَا. The people who were given money, they now listen to this and they are doing the same. They are saying Subhanallah walhamdulillah and they are taking more sadaqah. They want to be equal, right? And the Prophet said something very beautiful, very profound. He said, ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. This is the blessing of Allah. Allah is giving it to whoever He wants. My brothers, we all know, I'm sure like 90% of us know, that if you say Ayat al-Kursi, this simple ayah in the Quran, after every salah, you go to Jannah. The hadith says, the person who says Ayatul Kursi after every fard salah, there is nothing between him and Jannah except death. He just dies, he goes to Jannah straight away. We know it, right? Do we all do it? Probably not. Why? ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. We all know that Surah Al-Ikhlas, the small chapter that takes 3 lines in the Quran, is worth 1/3 of the Quran. تَعْدِلُ ثُلُثُ الْقُرْآنِ. Do we recite it much? Probably not all of us. We know that رَكْعَةَ الْفَجْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. The 2 rak'ah before the morning prayer, before Fajr, is better than the world and everything it contains. Do we consistently do it? The fortunate person does. The lucky person probably does. We know that the Prophet ﷺ says, whoever says Subhanallah wa bihamdihi fi yawmi 100 marra, if you say in a day Subhanallah wa bihamdihi 100 times, Allah removes all your sins, even if it was as massive, as numerous as Zabad al-Bahr, the foam of the sea. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi 100 marra. We know it. But did we say it today? Did we say it this week? Did we say it this month, this year? Probably the fortunate person does. We know that if when we listen to the adhan and we say the dua right after the adhan, Allahumma rabba hadhihi ad-da'wati at-tammah والصلاة القائمة آتي سيدنا محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة وبعثه اللهم المقام المحمود الذي وعدته إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. When you say this dua after hearing the adhan, you are granted the shafa'ah, the intercession of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on the day of judgment. We know that the night is 12 hours long and rak'at al-witr takes 3 minutes or probably less. And the fortunate people does it. My brothers, ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Among us today, probably one or two or maybe more would take one of these things or maybe more and add it to his day. Saying Subhanallah wa bihamdihi 100 times and you are forgiven of all your sins. Saying Ayatul Kursi after each fard prayer and you are granted Jannah. Saying the dua after you hear the adhan and you're granted the shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, probably the fortunate person will do it. My brothers, the wise man won't look at the person playing Monopoly and think he is a real winner. And a wise believer won't think or look at the wealthy person in this dunya and say he is the true winner. He's not. The true winner is the one who comes on the day of judgment and doesn't have to say this sentence, which a lot of people will say on the Day of Judgment. They will say, يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي. Oh, how I wish I had brought forth something for my life. I wish I had done some deeds for my life. And my life here doesn't mean this dunya life. It's nothing. When you compare this 60, 70, 100 years to the Day of Judgment, which is 50,000 years, it's nothing. Compared to eternity in Jannah, it's nothing. يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي. I wish I had done something for my life. My life is the real life that hasn't started yet. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us all among those who are winners in this dunya and in the afterlife. اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلي اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأخر الصلاة.